गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 10. टुडे वी आर हियर टू डिस्कस अबाउट द ग्रामर पोर्शन दैट यू हैव इन योर टेस्ट. एंड द थ्री पोर्शंस ऑफ ग्रामर आर मॉडल्स, पैराग्राफ एंड लेटर टू एडिटर. टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द राइटिंग फॉर्मेट ऑफ लेटर टू एडिटर, पैराग्राफ एंड व्हाट अबाउट द कॉमन पॉइंट्स ऑफ मॉडल्स. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेटर टू एडिटर. फॉर राइटिंग लेटर टू एडिटर, व्हाट इज द फॉर्मेट? Format of writing to letter to editor is, first we will write the sender's address. Just like if we are writing here exam hall Bokaro Jharkhand, this will be your address. This is sender's address, means who is sending this letter. Okay, this is your address. And above, after this, we have to leave one line, and after that we will write date. What is the date? Today is 25 August 2020. Now, what we will do the next, after leaving again one line, we will write the editor whom we are writing this letter, any name of daily newspaper just like the Hindu, where he, the place where the office is. I'm writing Delhi, New Delhi. This will be the editor's address. Okay, after that again leave one line. And what is the subject of writing? What is the subject? You will write the subject here. Subject is given in your question. Okay. After this, we will again leave one line and write, sir. The first line, the first starting line for the letter is through the column of your newspaper. Through the column of your newspaper or steep in newspaper, you can write to the column of steep newspaper. I would like to draw the attention of concerned authority towards what will be the problem. You will write here. After that, paragraph change, and second paragraph we will write the causes, and in the paragraph 3 we will write the suggestion. After completing these three paras, we will just do what is the conclusion of this letter. That is, thanking you after leaving this line. Thanking you, yours truly, and your name XYZ. Whatever your name is, you can write here. This is the format of letter to editor. Okay, you can easily do copy the format and you can do it in your test. And this is the right format for letter to editor. Again, we will discuss here about paragraph. What is paragraph? Paragraph is not an original part of class 10 syllabus, but here it is in your it is in here. And paragraph, what is paragraph? Paragraph is just about 100 words. We have to write a paragraph in just 100 words, and we don't have to change the paras. Just like in letters and articles we do, we don't have to change. Here we will combine all the things in a single paragraph, and paragraph could be on any topic, just like child labor. These are the common topics of paragraph, and we have to start up with the problem of child labor, and we will conclude everything in a single paragraph. Means we will start from here, and after that we will in the single paragraph. We will not change and nowhere we will mention the name, but just we have to write the topic here at the front, topic, and we will start writing the things below. Okay, this is paragraph. Now we will discuss about the models in just after erasing. You will do it after erasing. I will just discuss the models. Good morning, class 10. As I have said that I will give you a brief discussion on models, and this is the notes what the models are. Models are the words. Okay, are verbs. They are general, not words. They are verbs. Models are verbs which tells the mood of the sentence. The models are words which tells the mood of the sentence. And what are the general characteristics of model? How we can separate the models from others? Models is always used with principal verb. They can never be used alone. Means in any sentence, models cannot be used alone. Models have to be used with a principal verb. Means there should be a main verb in the sentence. And if the models are used before the main verbs. Okay. Second number, they do not change according to the number and person. Means models, these verbs do not change according to the number or person, number or person. Okay, this will not change. These are having a fixed form. They do not change their form. Commonly used models we will discuss here. What are the main commonly used models in our grammar book? These are nine most commonly used models in our grammar book, and three modes are there. That is needn't, dare not, and dare, need, or used to. These are the three semi models. They are not models, they are termed as semi models because they are used as models also, and they can be used as a main verb also. So they are semi models. Today we will discuss about the models. This will. Will, we all know that will is a word which is used to show the future. But where we will use will? Will is used with second and third person. Okay. Will is generally used with second and third person of subject. And what it shows? It shows intention. It shows intention. Means what we intend to do. Means we have not done yet. We have intended to do. Means we are thinking of doing it. This is showing the future tense. Okay, good. Past of will is would. And would is very important because would shows polite request. Would you give me your pen? This is a polite request. Determination is also shown by would, and it is past of will. You can easily form many of the sentences that will show polite request, determination in would. Shall, with used with first person, it is also used to show the future tense, and it shows promise, command, or assurance. Promise, command, assurance. Should is the past of shall, and it shows obligation, means we should do it. It is obliged to, means we are having, it's our moral duty to do. We should help the poor. This is an example. We should help the poor means we should help the poor. It is our moral duty to help the poor. Just like should, there is another model which is used in our grammar, that is ought to. Ought to is also used to show moral duty. Ought to is also used to show the moral duty. Okay, can. What is the use of can? Can is used to show ability. Means I can do it. This is the ability. What is your capacity? Permission. Can I go? This is what we say permission. Permission, an informal request. Any informal request, if you do, you will use can. Okay, good. Past of can, and it is used to show the past ability. Past ability, polite request, permission in the past. These are the things which are shown by can. Just like we say, could he come here? This is quotedly come here. This is a simple sentence. Quotedly come here. Okay. May grant permission. This is to grant permission. This is also to take permission also. Possibility is also shown by may. And wish and purpose is also shown. Jaise ki may God bless you. This is a wish. And might is the past of may. It shows doubtful possibility. Means possibility is there, but it is doubtful. Might it rain today. Means it is very less probability that it will rain today. Okay. Purpose and suggestions are also two things which are shown by might. And the last is must. Must is just to show obligation. Means you have the compulsion to do it. You have to forcefully do it. Just like you must come here tomorrow. Means you have no other option. You have to come here tomorrow. These are the common models that we use in our grammar books. Okay. Now I think you can easily tackle the problems which are given in you.